He was 79. His death was announced on Facebook by friend and fellow child star Paul Peterson. Showbiz and media figures we've lost in 2021. Photo gallery. My friend of many decades, Tommy Kirk, was found dead last night, wrote Peterson, who has long been an advocate for child actors through his organization A Minor Consideration. Tommy was intensely private. He lived alone in Las Vegas, close to his friend, Emil Yeller co-star, Bev Washburn, and it was she who called me this morning. Tommy was gay and estranged from what remains of his blood family. We in A Minor Consideration are Tommy's family. Without apology. We will take care of this. Kirk said in a 1993 interview with FilmFacts magazine writer Kevin Minton that he realized he was gay at age 17 or 18 and that his sexual orientation all but destroyed his career. Disney was a family film studio, and I was supposed to be their young leading man. After they found out I was involved with someone, that was the end of Disney. I consider my teenage years as being desperately unhappy, Kirk added in the interview. I knew I was gay, but I had no outlet for my feelings. It was very hard to meet people and, at that time, there was no place to go to socialize. It wasn't until the early 60s that I began to hear of places where gays congregated. The lifestyle was not recognized, and I was very, very lonely. Oh, I had some brief, very passionate encounters and as a teenager I had some affairs, but they were always stolen, back alley kind of things. They were desperate and miserable. When I was about 17 or 18 years old, he continued, I finally admitted to myself that I wasn't going to change. I didn't know what the consequences would be, but I had a definite feeling that it was going to wreck my Disney career and maybe my whole acting career. 1962, Savage Sam, an old Yeller sequel in 1963, The Misadventures of Merlin Jones, 1964, and The Monkey's Uncle, 1965, Kirk went on to appear in a string of the popular beach party movies of that decade.